Hey, I'm Andrew Baena from the deathcore band Carcosa. However, you might also recognize me from TikTok for screaming stupid pickup lines at ya, or from my YouTube channel, Andrew Baena, for gear demos and lots of low-tuned stuff like that. So real quick, just to talk about TikTok, me and Johnny had this idea to scream random pickup lines and stuff like that about 2 years ago, and it really started taking off this year for some reason. I wish I could say the idea was some genius strike of lightning, but honestly, it was probably the easiest idea we've ever thought of. We were just like, hey, breakdown callouts are cool. What if we make breakdown callouts, but they're funny instead? And that's pretty much it. And now here we are, 800,000 followers on TikTok later somehow. So I know some people think that TikTok is pretty cringe, and some of it is, but I mean, let's be honest, YouTube also was pretty cringe back in the day, and I'm sure people were also very hesitant to start YouTube. So TikTok is just the newest social media platform, and I'm sure most bands are gonna get on that real quick. As for has it actually helped in real life with Carcosa, yes, it definitely has. Almost every time a video goes viral on TikTok, we can see a direct correlation on Carcosa's analytics. Sometimes we get more listens to our music on the days those TikToks go viral than when we release brand new music. So yes, TikTok definitely is helpful in real life as well. So while me and my bandmate Johnny are perhaps more known for doing those silly TikTok videos, I'm actually primarily a guitar player, and today I want to talk about some of the riffs that made me start playing guitar and some of my favorite guitar riffs in general. So I think I started playing guitar back when I was 13, and at the time my favorite band was Linkin Park. I'm sure most of you guys know who they are, but they had a song called A Place For My Head, and for some reason the guitar riff in that song in particular just really made me want to learn how to play guitar. So it's quite a simple riff, it's just played like that, and it pretty much repeats throughout the whole song, but for whatever reason, I thought that riff was really cool and I wanted to learn it. As for the first guitar riff I ever learned, initially that A Place For My Head riff was too hard for me, so the first riff I ever learned was actually a song called Aerials by the band System of a Down. This riff is incredibly easy since it's just drop-tuned power chords. I vividly remember going over to my friend's house when I was like 12 or 13 before I had my own guitar, and I learned it on his guitar because he taught me how to play it. He had like a bunch of printed tabs he found from some bootleg site under his bed, and he showed me how to play it, and that was the first thing I ever learned. Of course, it's obviously tuned to drop C and a lot higher than that, but you get the point. So when I was growing up, I did have a guitar teacher briefly, but I foolishly told him to not teach me any theory because I was a young kid and I didn't see the value of it. And to this day, I still don't know any music theory because of that mistake. So yes, I had a guitar teacher for about a year or two, if I remember correctly. It was pretty informal. I think I only went like once a week for half an hour, and I kind of just got him to teach me the basics of basic techniques. And I eventually just stopped going because I decided that learning cover songs from guitar tabs was more fun. And here we are today. Really haven't progressed my skills since then much, but hey, here we are. So as with most guitarists, there were definitely some techniques I struggled with early on, and to be completely honest, there are tons of guitar techniques I still don't know to this day. However, one of the ones I vividly remember being quite difficult for me to get a hold of was pinch harmonics. For some reason, something about those was incredibly difficult for me, and I remember the song that really helped me get better at them was Laid to Rest by Lamb of God, which if I remember correctly goes like this. So yeah, that riff right there is something that helped me get better at pinch harmonics, something I could honestly still work on apparently. Some of the riffs I remember learning when I was younger that I still play to this day are Brace Legs by Born of Osiris and Namaste by Veil of Maya. For some reason, those two riffs in particular just always come back to me, and almost every day when I'm warming up, I have a tendency to just gravitate towards playing those riffs because they're just a really good exercise for both my left and right hand, and they use pretty much all the techniques that I normally use in my songwriting anyways. So first up is Brace Legs by Born of Osiris. Again, of course, this is in a much higher tuning than this, but you'll get the point. So that goes like this. Thank you. And the other riff is Namaste by Veil of Maya. Okay, so moving on, we're gonna talk about some riffs from my band, Carcosa. So I've picked three different riffs from my band. The first one is a riff from our song called Our Scars. The intro riff is very simple in a way, but it's very easy to mess up. And a lot of the riffs that I write, I have a tendency to feel that way. I also write a lot of like hammer-on riffs, and this is like just the best example of a hammer-on riff that I write. And it's a lot of fun to play, and this is how it sounds. So yeah, nothing too crazy to that one. However, I've seen a few people play it and they pick the whole thing. It's actually way easier to play if you just use hammer-ons. You just have to make sure your hammer-ons are big and strong. Stupid. The next riff I wanted to talk about from Carcosa is from our song titled Devoid. Once again, it's the intro riff to the song. Nothing too crazy, but it's a lot of fun to play. It sounds like this. Yeah, I don't know, something about that riff is always a lot of fun to play, and those big-ass chords just sound so nice to play, and it's fun. The last riff I want to talk about from Carcosa is from our song called Vanta Black. This is more of like a transitional riff between the intro and the first breakdown. I would say I like the breakdown more, but honestly, it would be super boring to show you guys, so I chose the transition riff instead. It's just focused a lot on bends, and it sounds like this. So Carcosa does have a full-length album coming out very soon on August 19th. The album is titled Anthology, and some of my favorite riffs from that album are actually on the second track of the album titled Hypnos. I don't know if that song is going to be out by the time this video airs, so here's a potential preview if you haven't heard it already. It's a lot of fun, and it sounds like this. Okay, that's all for this video. Thank you so much to Loudwire for having me. Again, go check out my band, Carcosa. We are releasing our brand new album, Anthology, very, very soon. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, and look forward to reading your comments.